Oh, hey. Question. Has this ever happened to you? Why? Why is this so hard? I don't understand. Why? 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 I know what you're thinking. No, Raccoon Facts, I've never had this problem. Like most people, I know how to flush a toilet. Who would even watch this video? Why would anybody watch this video? And to that I say, wow, I didn't know that my community hated people who didn't have arms. You armist, heartless frogs. So for this Alexa DIY, build it yourself, flushes toilet YouTube video on YouTube DIY, hashtag DIY, hashtag Alexa video, you need an Alexa. The next thing you're going to need is a microcontroller. I'm using the WeMos D1 Wi-Fi board. You can use the smaller ones and whatever you want to use for this for real. Link in the description below though. You're gonna need a servo, and the last thing you're gonna need is lots and lots of Coke. And also a spring, and a Velcro thing, and of course a power source. As you can see from this setup, the power part of the servo goes to the 5 volts, the brown wire goes to the ground, and then the trigger wire goes to pin number 13. I also just hung the spring into one of the holes in the servo. User mileage may vary on that. This just seemed to work really easily for me. And now, to the code. I don't know how to code. Okay, so now for the actual tutorial, go to cinric.com and register there. Once you make your account, go ahead and log in and take note of your API code and go to smart home device and click add. Just name it Fleshy Boy, Toilets, whatever you want to name it for real. Go down the description. You don't have to fill this out, but I went ahead and just said it was the toilet servo. And then for device type, I noticed that a lot of these work, but the one that I like to use the most is going to be switch at the top. At the top. At the top. There you go. Perfect. Then what you're going to want to do is go over to my PasteBin and copy it, and then paste it into Arduino's programming. If you don't know this program, Google it, learn it. It takes like a day. Grab your API code and copy. Then go down to the code where it says API key here and just go ahead and put the API key right there. Then where it says my SSID, put your Wi-Fi name, and then I went ahead and put my password in, which is password, you have to do it as well. Then you want to head down to the first if statement and you want to grab the ID from Fleshy Boy and you want to just copy it and paste it right there in that first if statement. Don't put it in any of the other statements in this little area, like the else or the else if or anything like that. Go down to the second if statement. This should be for turn off, and go ahead and put that device ID on the top right there as well. After this, you want to go ahead and upload it to your device and then head over to the Alexa app. Once in the Alexa app, you're going to want to add a new device, and then let's see, you're going to want to scroll all the way down to other, Discover devices. This takes about 45 seconds, as it says. We're going to speed up a little. And then, of course, it found our switch. You don't have to add it to a group. I just skipped it for this part of the tutorial. And then it's set up. Now head over to the pancakes, go to routines, and then add a routine. You can name this anything. I just named it Fleshy. And then for the trigger, you want to do voice and Alexa flush the toilet. And then for the actions, you want to go ahead and scroll down to smart home, all devices, and then choose toilet. Power on. Then go to add action again, smart devices, or smart home, all devices, and then toilet one more time, but this time have it turn off. And then add an action for Alexa to say something to you. I just chose, because I'm always forgetting, put the seat down. All right. And that is pretty much it. Just save it, and you're all set. So hopefully not that hard. Let's look at the setup. So as you can see, I just attached the spring directly to the plunger, added Velcros to attach the servo and the board, and it is all being powered by this white power source, diversity power source, and that is all it requires. It's actually a pretty simple build for the servo though. I didn't want to do anything permanent. That's why I added the Velcro straps things. I got 16 pounds for those of you who were curious. I just saw the highest one at Walmart and picked those up. And then of course you need your Alexa. So let's just do this one more time.
Alexa, flush the toilet.
Don't forget to subscribe to our
podcast. So I hope you liked the video. Leave a like and a comment, subscribe, whatever. Really what I'm going to be doing is a lot more Alexa tutorials or a lot more DIY projects along these lines. So thanks. Have a great one.